Who knew moving 1,000 miles away to be overworked and underpaid by a mouse would lead me to my best friend and love of my life? It was at the moment when I saw you standing in 100-degree heat at the end of the People Mover queue line holding a sign that says line ends here, looking like you'd rather be anywhere else in the world, that I knew what I was looking for. You. It's always been you. From our first date all the way up until this moment. You're my first thought in the morning. You're my dream at night. I am yours, now and always. And all I can say is thank you. Thank you for loving me through all of my highs and lows. Thank you for loving me when we did not know where life was taking us, but we had each other. And thank you for loving me even though my family is the reason that hat companies changed one size fits all to one size fits most. You know me better than anyone else in the world, and somehow you still manage to love me. You're my best friend and one true love. There's still a part of me today that cannot believe that I'm the one that gets to marry you. I see these vows not as promises, but as privileges. I get to laugh with you and cry with you. I get to care for you and share with you. I get to run with you and walk with you, build with you and live with you. I also get to eat all the leftover Orange Sour Patch Kids at the bottom of the bag. And all through life's changes, I get to love you. You're my best friend, and I give you my heart today with all that I am and all that I can be, to be by your side forevermore. I love you.
When I was a little girl, I used to dream of Prince Charming and Happily Ever After. Seriously, I used to watch Beauty and the Beast 4 times a day for years. But as I got older, those dreams turned to prayers. Instead of dreaming of my Prince Charming, I started praying for a life partner. Someone who was kind, selfless, and who would love me despite my flaws. I had no idea that one day God would answer my prayers and introduce me to someone who was everything I prayed for more. 4 years ago, after our fourth date, I called my mom on the phone and told her I was going to marry you. I'm pretty sure she thought I was crazy, but I meant it. I knew you were the one. It's always you, then you, and always will be you. One thing I love about you is your humor. Even though I can't tell you too much, I have to keep you humble. You never fail to make me laugh, even when I don't want to or really shouldn't. Another thing I love about you is how much you feel like home. I've always told you, ever since I was a little girl, Disney felt like home. And shortly after moving there, I met you. So I guess you could say it really is the place where dreams come true. You are my comfort, my safe place, and the best home I've ever known. Anyone who knows you knows that you have the biggest heart and would do anything for the people you love. You're the most selfless person I know, and you never fail at making me feel like the most beautiful woman in the world. You are the best pet dad. You love Piper and Remy unconditionally, and I know one day you'll make the best pet human dad, too. Over the last 4 years, I've fallen more in love with you than I thought was possible, and I can't wait to start this next chapter together as husband and wife. So, Patrick, for the rest of my life, I promise to love you more during the storms than during even the most perfect days of our marriage. I promise to put you first and always be faithful. I promise to be your biggest fan and always take care of you when you're sick, even if you're being dramatic. I promise to always appreciate you and never take your love for granted. I promise to be the best mother to our future children. I promise to encourage your dreams, to stand by your side during our most joyous moments and our most challenging, and always work as a team. I promise to always say I'm not hungry and then eat all your food anyway. I promise to be patient and always speak to you with kindness and compassion. I promise to always take adventures with you. I promise to let you win every once in a while in Mario Party and Play 9. I promise to learn from you, even when I have a hard time accepting when I'm wrong. I promise that no matter what challenges we face, I will continue to choose you every day for as long as I live. Most importantly, I vow to kiss you goodnight and love you more tomorrow than I do today. I promise to support the man you are today, the husband you'll be tomorrow, and the person you hope to become. I've loved you for 1,478 days, and I promise to continue choosing you and loving you for the rest of my life. I can't wait for this life with you. You're my best friend, my lobster, and my greatest adventure. I love you most.
I found a love for me, darling, just dive right in, follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell in, not knowing what it was. I will not give you up this time. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes you're holding mine. Baby, I'm between my arms, barefoot on the grass, we're listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling. You found a woman stronger than anyone I know. She shares my dreams. I hope that someday I'll share her home. I found a love carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own.
Breathtaking Bride's little sister, maid of honor, and best friend. When Emily and Patrick first asked me to speak, I was extremely nervous and hesitant. But then I remembered that I get to talk about two of my favorite people. Emily, you look incredible. Disney princesses couldn't even compare to the beauty that radiates from inside out. Being your little sister has truly been one of God's greatest gifts, and I'm sure if my younger self heard me say that, she would be very, very confused. We may not have been the best of friends growing up. We may have been forced to take many, many pictures together, but I think that gave us a great foundation for our friendship today. Like you said the other day, we only used to want to strangle each other 70% of the time, but now it's about 30% and can easily be fixed with some food and a hug. You may not know this, but my entire life, you have been the woman that I look up to the most. Your strength, generosity, and perseverance has shaped me into the woman I am today, and I could not be more grateful. You taught me how to braid my hair, how to shave my legs, all the best cheat codes on Sims, that curling irons really hurt when they touch your skin, and that I can't breathe underwater. But that one, I had to learn the hard way. Nevertheless, the favorite lesson you've ever given to me, I learned through you and your better half. Together, Emily and Patrick taught me what it means to be a loving and supportive partner. When I lived with the two of them, I had the opportunity to see their relationship up close and get the inside scoop on what goes on behind closed doors. What I saw between Emily and Patrick was nothing other than true love and compatibility. And most importantly, I saw the dual effort to support each other and maintain a healthy partnership. You know the kind, daily jabs and jokes, and Emily taking out the trash once for every time, five times that Patrick does. Sorry, I messed that up. Oh, God. You ready for this? Patrick, I can't put into words how perfect you are, not only for my sister, but for our family. I truly cannot be prouder to call both of you my best friends. Neither of you have ever failed to be there for me whenever I need, and I know that I am not the only person here that can say that. I knew you two were meant to be when I met Patrick and Disney, and you guys were like two little kids, clearly in love, running all around Disney, showing me all of the hidden gems. Oh, I could also tell, by the way, that Patrick was staring at my sister. I couldn't imagine giving my best friend to anyone else. Of all of the amazing qualities you possess, my favorite is that you never fail to make her laugh, even if it means you're poking fun at her. Emily, thank you for being the best big sister and role model I could ever ask for. And Patrick, thank you for being an incredible partner and for raising my standards. You two have endured every challenge and every blessing as a team, and it has only made you stronger. I have no doubt that your love will only blossom throughout the many victories, sicknesses, and obstacles for many years to come. May you prosper in health, wealth, and happiness. And most importantly, may you have the time to enjoy it all. I love you two so much, and I wish you nothing but the best as you enter this journey together as husband and wife. Please look into each other's eyes and know that you are looking into the eyes of the person that is statistically most likely to marry you. To Patrick and Emily.
First off, congratulations. It has been an incredible ride since the Bird of Paradise days. honestly, I still remember walking in on one day home from work. I was coming in and I see Emily sitting there and she was on her laptop working her butt off. I think at this point she was doing like three classes, working like a 50-hour work week at Guest Relations at Magic Kingdom. And then there's Patrick. He is passed out, sleeping, like leaning up against her. And you know, congrats to Emily for finding someone who will not be bugging her while she's working. He may be sleeping, but he won't be bugging her. I also want to say thank you, because you two are two of the best friends I have ever had. You are genuinely two of the most loving people I have ever met. I think everyone here has experienced that. You just show love so well. And I think that's a big reason why we're here today. You just know how to show love. Whether it be with, you know, friendships, family, or even with each other. So congratulations, thank you so much. And I'm excited to see where you two will grow from here on out.
I love you so much.
Hi, I'm Courtney. Emily and I met in 2018, which really seems recent, but I felt like I've known her my whole life. I've never met a friend that's more like me, but we don't fight. We really compliment each other, but we were roommates in the Disney College program, and let me tell you learn a lot about someone real fast when you have six girls living in a three-bedroom apartment. I'll spare Emily all the embarrassing stories, because I think her dad covered that pretty well. But hang on. I learned really quickly how genuine, loving, and caring Emily is. She has a heart bigger than anyone I have ever met. Then I moved away after the Disney College program, and she stayed at Disney. And that's actually when we got closer, because we relied on one another to really just get through everything in life, even though we were so far away. So I was coming back with my husband to visit And she told me that she had a boyfriend that she wanted me to meet. And I was very skeptical. I was nervous because I didn't think anyone would be good enough for you. And then I met Patrick. And Patrick, you complete Emily in every way possible. And you encourage one another, prioritize one another, and love each other unconditionally. And when I see y'all together, I see true love. I can't wait to see what your future holds, and I'll be there every step of the way being y'all's biggest cheerleader. And I love you both. So cheers to Emily and Patrick.
That was perfect.
Mwah.
Love you.
Creeping in, illuminates our skin. We watch the day go by, stories of what we did. It made me think of you, it made me think of you. Under a trillion stars, we danced on top of cars, took pictures of. If these wings